Demon and Demon is probably the most common battle on the last floor. I seem to see it a lot. Almost there. Demon and Demon are just following me every step of the way. They're gonna kill Petrus, probably? Maybe not. Right. So I'm gonna, like, I've used all of Petrus's MP, but I'm gonna try and keep him alive just as a target for the walk to Kinnear. So I'll walk to Knave that good, will make up for a few seconds here and there. Here, Petrus, hold on to this key. While you're at it, get naked. I want the value of those Wayfarer's clothes. You too, Windar, you get naked too. It's a rule of this game. Every character must be naked at one point or more. Yeah, given how long the walk took, it's especially surprising that everyone survived. I wasn't even thinking about that. Kill on the first round, alright. There are actually two battles that go this way. Two rounds. with some cereal. Get the way these games are supposed to be played. Casual run of Dragon Warrior 3, you're supposed to find the echoing flute and then play it every single time you enter any location, any cave, any little transport cave, any town, and that's the way you're supposed to go after the orbs. So if a player has not done that, he's never played the game before, it could take him a very long time to find it. Yeah, Geolora, it's not a huge thing, but every once in a while you encounter a battle that takes 40 or 50 rounds. And you just want to avoid that. It's free time, and it only took... How long did it take to manipulate these battles? Probably 16 hours, something like that. There's 16 different paths. I'd like to think I spent about an hour on that. He already went to the town. Well, did he play the echoing flute? Does he know there's an orb there? That's the question. If not, he could be stuck forever without it. Yeah, the merchant tells you where the orb is, that's right. Has 24 HP, below average, but not worth worrying about that. To get away on the second attack. Stop targeting the fighter. Not a major setback to lose a character in this section, but every time you have to revive someone, it takes a little time. I was gonna say, it would be cool to have a deathless run, but PR actually just about to come up to a section where we suicide on purpose. I mean, I guess you could, like, we could say non-intentional deaths. Non-intentional deathless run. We also kill off a soldier on purpose during the battle of the metal slimes. Okay, you've got 3 slots, drop this. And then a whole lot of herbs. By the way, our time of arrival here is above average. We're at speed right now. I walk through the desert. Yeah, before I started playing, I watched the physics game that kind of looks like Portal, but isn't. I forget what its name is, but it's really cool that John DeLancey narrates the game. And I also watched the Wolfenstein port and Super Noah's Ark 3D, or whatever it's called, which is just awesome. Hey, Gronk, welcome. I've always wanted to play Noah's Ark, and I guess now I can, now that there's a Steam port. I imagine it would be very hard to try and find a SNES card of it. And I believe you also need some sort of plug-in to play it on the SNES, otherwise it won't work properly, like either a double-sided cartridge or like a SNES Game Genie or something like that. Exactly what it is. I am not a SNES kid. Yeah, Grok, ultimately sub 330, like, is the goal, and I would be happy with anything sub 330. Taking a look at what's possible, it gets a little scary. But I'd be very happy with just sub 330. First try. successful runs here. I took two extra steps, but that's not going to matter because every single time I get the magic key, it's always quite a few steps before the next battle. So it's very unlikely that that extra two steps is going to yield an extra battle. All four of them, Grok, on the NES, and I'm mostly, almost exclusively an NES player. So, the next Dragon Warrior will not be for a long time, because I have a lot of NES projects I want to do first. Good progress here so far. Yeah, I have a lot of interest in FF1. Technically, there's not much that separates it from the Dragon Warrior series. I should really include it as one of the three best games of all time on the NES. There's no question in my mind, like, for me, it outranks Dragon Warrior 1 and 2. Not because there's anything wrong with the first two, but because Final Fantasy was just that good. Super nice. And of course, the music. Possibly the best soundtrack. Oh, whoops. Possibly the best soundtrack of anything on the NES. It's funny, I didn't know the stair glitch existed until just recently. I suppose I could do it, but it wouldn't mean that much to me. It's not playing the game through. Like, it's obviously a separate category. Just another wrong warp that happens to exist. I would certainly give it a go for the novelty aspect. But, you know, ultimately I'm interested in this warp. Okay, so you're using one, you're selling two, so you're good for space for zero. Soldier's gonna move two over. Let's see where we have space. Drop that. And we'll give one to each. 1-2-0. 1-2-F. I think I need one additional space on the hero for the arm band. I'm not sure why that is. But I'll figure it out in a second. There's a chance I'll have to drop an herb. We have... Oh, that's totally what it is! I didn't use the hero's herb to avoid that battle. We have absolute maximum herb capacity right now, which is nice to know. Usually that doesn't happen. Half. gave NES game ranking much thought beyond the fact that I think Dragon Warrior 3 and 4 are the two best games on the NES. And I haven't given it any thought beyond that, but I just sort of realized that Final Fantasy 1 would probably be my pick for number 3, and very close to the other two. Yeah, I remember watching him go through one of the classes. I think it was the White Mage. That was something to behold. Definitely a cool project, and I'm sure he's very proud of himself for completing it. I'm pretty sure he kept it as a White Mage, no upgrade. Yeah, someone mentioned that in my chat just this week, and I was certainly very happy to hear that the series is still continuing. It's a wonderful thing. Black Mage may sound rougher than White Mage, but I believe Black Mage is much easier. Inventory is now full except for that one space that the hero has after using that thing. Poison toads. That's really silly. I don't want to go through this whole walk with three characters poisoned. And I'm going to have to unpoison them anyway, so I might as well just do it here instead of the next town. Though I didn't encounter any poison toads before. Wow. Yes, you did, Grog. Thank you. Tortoga, that makes up some poison toads. Almost complete. That's really sweet. So our time is still above average. The fighter has two wings. One is going to be for going to Aseran, and the other is going to be for going back to Aliahan to heal in the middle of the round. And that will pick up a couple extra wings when we go there. Hero gets the Royal Scroll. Uh-oh, you know what it's time for. It's time for Norrin Hype! Is he down the well? No, I feel like we've looked everywhere. There he is! Sitting in his chair, that's so Norrin. Ahem! 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 Can I get an ahem? As important to the entire run as any NPC in the game. Norrin. Okay, this is a good battle. Nice job, hero. Nice, I like it. Take this battle all the way down. Ooh, I missed two of them. We got him. Let's keep it going. Nice smooth trip so far. Relatively low encounter rate. Battle I have to fight. Nice, we got one out of the way. No fireballs yet. Nice, zero fireballs. We are going to heal the wizard here. This is nice, we've got a good time going, everything's going right. None of the characters are... We haven't encountered any dangerous battles on this leg yet. Only one expel left after this. Boatload of safety heals. Gonna give one to each character, much faster than reviving the character later. And let's keep going. We are in there, and... Oh, you know what? I was gonna say I don't have to, stay at the inn, but I need the hero's MP back. Or I want it back, rather. It's worth a little walk here. That's actually very realistic Zergling with an optimal design. Like if I start getting triple loops and stuff like that. We've seen it happen before. It's within the realm of possibility. It's just not one of the likely scenarios. Very nice walk here. We're already into the bigger enemies, which is what we want to see. Not that we want to actually see any enemies on this leg, but that's really nice. Nice, we got away first try. Boom! Wow, that was spectacular. I believe 47 is my best ever Dama arrival time. I've done it a few times. This is one. Here's hoping for a good grind. Yeah, it not being a gold split has everything to do with the fact that the split before was good too. So it's not like I was late arriving at the previous junction and then I got here fast to make up for it. Just halt. Alright, so we're gonna approach this the same way we always do and just hope that everything goes better than last time. Hope everything goes above average. It'd be nice to open with a double, but I'm a little pessimistic. We're already down to, yeah. So we're just hoping for a single now, of course. Okay, he stuck around. We got it. The grind has begun. It is so nice to get the Dama in 47 minutes. Some HP on our wizard. He is still in a bit of a danger zone right now. So let's see what he gets here. He was at 24. He can get up to 6 here. Nice! The full 6. He's up to 30 already. And another 6. That makes 36. Very nice. Zergling with the patented trademark Zergling Metal Slime counter. Also, as a side note, wow, the soldier has very high max HP right now. That's very cool. Definitely always nice to get the first one to beat. That's why I have so much hype over a double kill in the first round, because it is not that common in occurrence. Especially with everyone's low agility and everything. Alright, we've got 2 targets left. Damage to Metal Slime D. Nice! There's a critical. We've got a good shot at a double here. Yes! Double hype! This is a phenomenal start to the grind. Getting here this early. 3 kills in the first 2 battles. Zergling had the double kill feeling. He was correct. Feliong was correct. Major hype. Yeah, triples are sweet, but believe me, I am always, always very, very happy with them. Soldier's already over 100 max HP, and he's not even level 14 yet. That's absolutely correct, Zerkling. Single. Ah, he got away. Darn. No big deal. Not. Wow. Wow, that sucks. Well, if I zone out too much, Brian Good, I can take a few extra steps here and there. So, I mean, there's a lot of muscle memory, but I do have to be pretty careful. Alright, I'm gonna try switching up my attack pattern here.
Ninja Spear!
Time is still really good. Right?